Right, absolutely. And Prasanna, also tell us, you know, you speak of technology, you speak about digitization and how it's penetrated our life and how it's in fact changed everything. You know, people you would least expect to be inclined towards the digital medium are adept at it today. But, you know, the contention or rather the apprehension is that when will it actually start to help the rural population of our country, which in a way does not have the wherewithal, the apparatus also to deal with this digital revolution?
It is a process, but it is extremely encouraging to see the kind of adoption that is happening. I mean, I could certainly talk about the business that we do. When we started out, we really found that, you know, there is no visibility of agriculture warehouses across the country. Even the finance minister had spoken about it in the last budget, where we talked about geotagging of all agriculture warehouses. So being a post-harvest services company, we have digitized agriculture warehouses. And today as we speak, though it is a small number, we have about 3,000 agriculture warehouses listed across 300 districts of the country, where farmers, farmer producer organizations, and small aggregators could locate a warehouse, can select a warehouse on more than 100 parameters. Now, the platform also brings in finance, because if you want to store your produce, you would require finance and avail finance to be able to bridge that working capital gap. And finally, you are able to sell the produce on the platform itself. With the disruption of markets, you know, these services have been essential. So we've seen a significant growth in terms of people intending to store the produce rather than selling it at distress values. So it is a rational need. And our belief is that the product that you design has to be designed keeping in mind the reality of the end consumer that you're trying to service. So if you're trying to service a farmer, you will have to make your UX, you have to make your UI, you have to make your platform understandable by that particular target audience. And I think that's going to be extremely critical. With the kind of advances in technology, with the kind of use of AI, I think making that possible is, making that happen is certainly possible. You know, using a voice bots, for example, or making sure that what you want to offer to that end consumer is understood by them. You know, just to give you a small example, because we really sometimes feel that, you know, these are farmers, they probably do not understand technology. But if you see the penetration of Facebook and YouTube in these markets is exceptionally high. I mean, maybe today in the urban audiences, we find that, you know, probably Facebook isn't so cool. Maybe Instagram is, or maybe a few other platforms are. But in the rural markets, Facebook still continues to be extremely relevant. And we'll have to find ways, keeping in mind the realities of the market that exist. And, you know, and I really see, and I'm extremely hopeful that many entities like us and companies like us would certainly follow these needs.
Superb.